Hello everyone, welcome to Writing Quest. My name is Brennan Pugh, and in today's episode, we're going to talk about how I've started using Scrivener to work on the manuscript of this novel, and I'm going to show you some tips and tricks on how you can use it yourself. Huzzah! All right, everyone, welcome to Writing Quest. So we are talking about Scrivener today. Scrivener is a writing program that has been around for quite a while. It's in its third version. I started out when I first started writing using this program. I moved away from it, started using Ulysses for a while, and then I started using Notion. So I'm back to Scrivener, and I'm going to give you a couple reasons why that is, while also kind of showing you a little bit about how it works. Ulysses is a great program. I loved using Ulysses. Part of the reason I'm not wanting to use it really anymore is, one, it's a subscription base, so you have to pay like $5 a month every month, and I just didn't want to do that anymore. I did like that I could have all of my manuscripts for all of my writing in one spot, and you could have it all open. I do like that. However, sometimes that's a little overwhelming because you have access to all of it at the same time. So sometimes it's nice to only have access to some of it. And then, of course, the paid thing, I just wanted to get away from that. Whereas Scrivener, you pay for it once, you have for it for forever. So Notion, of course, is a great way. I'm going to still be using that to outline and keep track of the projects, but I'm not going to be doing my writing in there because a couple of reasons. One of them is that just being able to keep track of the writing is going to be easier in this program. So let's jump into it and get to the computer screen. Okay. So this is the main screen for Scrivener. Now you can only have one thing open at once. So if you opened up a different manuscript, it would be a whole other screen. So in this, I've got Legends of the Scaredoth, part one of Wolves and Wizards, and this is where our manuscript. I've got our manuscript broken down into Act 1, Act 2, and Act 3, and then ideas. The biggest advantage to Scrivener is being able to do all this breakdown that you can actually see. You can get very granular when you need to, but also keep it all organized, shuffle things around. You have a couple different views here at the top. We're going to show that first. So this is the documents view. So if you go into this, because I have this whole document selected, it's going to show me every single word I've written with these little page breaks there to show where things are broken. Not very useful in this particular with all this selected. But the main thing, the really awesome way to do it is this corkboard view, which gives you these things which you can drag them around. Which as in three-act structure doesn't help you as much, but you'll see once we get down into Act 1, I've got all these kind of scene cards. So I've got Chapter 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, all the way down to 12. Each one has the synopsis written on the card. So what's really cool about that is if I needed to, I could just kind of drag things around, reorder them how I needed. If I wanted to put this scene there, put it there. All of that stuff. And then, of course, you can get even more granular when you go into the individual chapters. So the folders, how I have it set up is the folders are set up as chapters, and then the documents inside are scenes within that chapter or parts of the chapter. The reason I've done this is because I really want to make sure that each chapter has a solid beginning, middle, and end, and possibly other parts in between. It also helps me to focus on, okay, I'm just writing the beginning of this chapter, so I don't have to think about some of the end stuff. It just kind of keeps it organized. So that's kind of the main breakdown. And then I have it in Act 1, Act 2, Act 3. So in my Act 2, this is where we get into the travelogue kind of part of the book. So the beginning part is they're kind of in the village. It's kind of the whole inciting incident, kicks them out of the village, all that kind of thing. So I've currently got things kind of broken down into obstacles 1, 2, 3, and 4. So these are kind of be the kind of the physical moments in the story that elevate, you know, they're trying to get here from point A to point B. This is in front of them. They can't do it. And then within woven throughout all of that is going to be the different story elements. So obstacle one, I've got about roughly three chapters in there. Obstacle two, I've got quite a few in there because I want that to be a pretty big one. And then, of course, I've got some other things here. What I just really like that I can break it down. And then, of course, you can always, you know, if I'm done with Act 1, I'm only working on Act 2, I can only have that open. And, of course, if you go into each one of these obstacles, you can rearrange the chapters in that way. And then, of course, each chapter, I'll eventually have a beginning, middle, and end. I just really like how granular you can get to things. And then when you get to Act 3, I've got a standard... I kind of went with a standard number of chapters, and so I've got those broken up by percentages. So that'll kind of adjust as we go. This is the main reason why I've switched back over to Scrivener, because you can break it down like this so easily. And then, of course, there is a ideas where I've just have a couple of the older things I've written that maybe I'll come back to and bring back, but not quite there yet. Some of the other fun features of Scrivener that I really like is, so in each one of these, you can do a snapshot. So I say I've written this. This is the very beginning little history of the high people that I've written. If I go over here and click that button, this is where I can keep all my snapshots. Now, why do we want to do this? Well, it's basically just versions. So if I'm going to rewrite this, what I will do is I will click a snapshot, which adds a snapshot here. So first draft, untitled, I'll title it, has the date. I can keep taking snapshots as I do revisions, and so I can always go back to what I'd previously written, so you never lose anything. But whereas some things, like a Ulysses has a versions system, but in this particular one, I really like that it's a little more manual, so it's intentional, and you can see the dates. It's just I really like the layout, basically. And so you can go back, and as I change things here, this stays the same, so I can always go back and reference my old drafts. You can also do a lot of other things, like different labeling. So I can go here, I can add a label. I haven't set those up as anything just yet, but you can. You can also set the status. So this particular thing is a first draft. I've got that marked. And then as you go, you can have your snapshots as the old drafts, and then you can change it and update the labels as you go. So that's kind of a rundown of Scrivener. Another cool view you have, if you go back here, you hit this view. So this view I really like because it kind of gives you some of the status stuff of everything. So it gives you total words. If you right click here, you can add a bunch of other different ways of doing things. But I personally have like this set up, and then you can go like this. You can see the whole breakdown of everything. Really nice way to see all the info and, change different aspects of things as far as your labeling goes. And then of course you can open it even further and you can see the different scenes that you have inside and what the word counts are and all that kind of stuff. So ultimately this is why I'm coming back to using Scrivener as my main writing tool. I think it's going to be much better as keeping the manuscript in order and keeping myself organized as I write. So that's a breakdown of Scrivener. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, please hit that like button, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Thank you for following Writing Quest, and we'll see you next time. Huzzah!